What is a probe? Probe plays a very vital role in the simulation output. There is one option called probe setup options. And when we click on that option, this window will come up. And here you can set different parameters for the probe. So in the practical demonstration with the PSpice software, we shall show you that how to set up this probe options. Here is the demonstration for you. Probe is a program which can take the data from an electrical circuit and it provides a variety of graphical displays on the user's request. Also, probe is a graphical results analyzer. So before going for the probe, at first we should do the setup for the probe respectively. So for that purpose, we shall have to go to the analysis option and then we shall go to the probe setup. So here we are having one dialog box with three tabs. So in the first tab, it is a common default choice that is automatically run probe after simulation and show all markers. If it is not necessary to change these options, if it is not required very urgently, otherwise we can work with the default option selected in the probe setup. So that is my data collection. So here the data collection will be done for all data will be collected, or you can go for at markers only and so on. So these are the four options that are there. And after collecting this data, the text data file format will be CSDF if you check this one. CSDF means Common Simulation Data Format. So the last option is the checkpoint. So here we can set the checkpoints as required. So these are the three tabs are there in the probe setup options. And now I shall show you that how this particular circuit, which is Astable Multivibrator using 555 timer, here the probe setup can be done and the respective simulation, how the simulation can be done, we shall show that one into details. To simulate this circuit, we are keeping our probe setup with the default options. So to simulate this one, we should have to go to the analysis. We can click on the simulate. The F11 can also be pressed. Otherwise, you can click on this option. Before going for the simulation, we should do the respective setup analysis. So if you click on the setup analysis, so here we are going to go for the transient option. Bias point detail is the default option which will remain selected. So if you click on the transient, here the print step I have given here 0.1 second and final time, that is the total time for which the simulation will be shown, that is 6 seconds respectively. So now if you click on the close, coming out and clicking on this simulate. So then a separate simulate window will come. So in this simulate window, we are getting the desired output as required. So this is my x-axis. Along the x-axis, we have plotted time. And along the y-axis, we have plotted VC1, that is voltage across C1 and voltage across R3 resistance. So this green marker is denoting, this line is for this VC1, and red marker is indicating that this particular line, whatever has been shown in the simulation output, is for voltage across R3. Okay, now we can change this x-axis variable by double clicking on this. So here we are having this x-axis, we are having the y-axis if you want to change something, and then we are having this x grid and y grid. So these are the options you can select, you can change, but it is better to work with the default options, because if you don't have any particular need, then you need not to go for this x grid or y grid tabs. In case of x-axis, we can change the variable as I was telling about that. So just keeping our selection on the x-axis tab, we are clicking on this axis variable. So here we are having so many variables are there which can be put at the x-axis. Here we have selected time. Otherwise, you can also go for other. Say we are selecting, replacing this time, we are selecting this, say, IC1. Say we are going to have some function over it. So in that case, we can go for, in this way, we can go for, say, log of this IC1. So that will be the x-axis variable. So x-axis variable can be set along with some functions as required. So here we are having list of different functions are there. which are available in the student version of PSpice. So let me stick with my old first one, that was the time here. So just replacing it by time. So in this way, we can change the x-axis variable as required. We can also change the y-axis. Here the y-axis is ranging from minus 5 volt to 10 volt. We can also make it say 0 volt to 5 volt, say minus 1 volt to 5 volt if I require. So that is my, so minus 1 volt to 5 volt, so the y-axis has been changed. So in this way, we can change it. If we require, we can go to the y-axis, we can change these parameters. Okay, now let us plot this VC1, that is the voltage across the condenser C1 in a different plot window. In that case, I can select this and I can press del to delete it from here. Then I shall go to plot. I shall go to add plot to window. So this is another window I have got. So now here I shall go for trace. I shall go for add trace and then I shall go for VC1. So that is voltage. So I do not want to see the currents. So VC1, I have selected this one. So here we have plotted two separate lines in two separate plot windows. In this way, we can do it. Now I shall show you how to bring the probe cursor here. So I'm selecting the upper plot window and clicking on this icon, that is the toggle cursor. If you click here, then automatically probe cursor will come. And here it is giving you the X and Y coordinates, that is our respective time and the respective VC1. So they are getting plotted. So here it is here. Now you see here you can go for cursor movement keys. You can press the cursor movement keys and accordingly we are finding that how the crosswire is moving through the graph, whatever has been drawn for VC1. So in this way you can get the lowest value. So here the lowest value is this is my 1.1, that is, this is the coordinate, there is a 1.1, this is the coordinate I'm having, and 3.0311, so that means this is my 3.0311. it is 0, it is 5, so here we are having 1 volt for each division, so it is almost 3, and it really it is actually 3.0311. in this way, using your cursor movement keys, you can move your crosswire over this line which has been drawn against VC1, and you can easily calculate the respective VC1 across the time values depending upon your crosswire position. So we have shown you that how to do the simulation, how to bring different curves and variables to be plotted, how to change the axis variables, how to bring the probe cursor, how to do the calculation of the relative X and Y on the graph points, and so on. And in this way, in all experiments, whatever we have done in this tutorial, we have done the simulation accordingly. Thanks for watching this video.